Today I'm doing a day hike of the Knobstone Trail here in southern Indiana. I've already done the full 40-ish miles, but when I was preparing for the AT, today I'm just doing a fun day trip out here. It's a very cool day for June. It's like in the 60s, and there's all kinds of wildflowers on the road, so can't wait to see what the forest looks like. This is gonna be great.
Was it though?
When I pulled up to that parking lot, there was someone in a truck next to me, a group of people I think just hanging out, and they were watching me. They were kind of staring at me, wondering, who's this person? What are they about to do? First, I walked all the way down that way because I thought that's where the trail was, and came back and kind of looked like a tourist, I guess. And now I'm walking all the way this way and I still don't see the trail, so that's kind of embarrassing. Also, when I was putting this jacket on, I just washed it and I had it zipped when I washed it, but I didn't remember that. Is this the trail? No, it is some gravel road. Man, I really think it's this way though.
It wasn't.
Anyway, I was putting on this jacket. I forgot that it was zipped, so it was like stuck on my head, and then I couldn't get the zipper undone for a while, so just, those people are probably like, man, that girl's dumb, but I can't help it. All right, is that the trail? Still no. And I'm not even to the actual trail yet.
This is me. This is what I thought the trail was.
This might finally be it. There's the horse route, except looks like a lot of tall grass I don't really want to go through. Sign over there saying this is a private drive, so that's not it. I'm really hoping this is it. I checked Google Maps and this is it, because the northbound route looks very full of grass and I don't feel like getting bug bitten all over my legs. I'm just gonna go southbound, which when I hiked it last year in the winter, I was coming northbound, so that'll be cool to see what the trail looks like heading in a different direction. Plus, it was winter back then, so I'm sure it'll look really different in general. Now, this does not look like an official trail, but there is this over here. So I guess so. I remember this trail has mile markers, like signs telling you what mile you're on the whole time. So once I see one of those, I'll know I'm in the right spot. So, funny plot twist, I'm not actually on the Knobstone Trail after all. I was headed for just a green dotted line on Google Maps, which is usually what maps are not, what trails are marked as, but it never actually said this was the Knobstone Trail, it just showed a trail. So I looked on all trails, you know, cross-referencing, and this isn't the trail at all. But it does hook up with the Knobstone eventually, so more to explore, you know? I'll just keep going, get on the Knobstone, eventually head back to my car. The only thing I'm thinking of is the people in the parking lot that were staring at me, being like, oh, this girl doesn't know where she's going, and I really didn't. But hey, if I come out the Knobstone Trail, that'll show them. Those strangers I'll never see again that probably don't care about me as much as I'm feeling self-conscious about. Here we go. This must be the northbound way back to my car. So let's meander a little bit down this way. I almost walked right past this because it's here hiding behind a tree. Mile 11 on the Knobstone Trail. So when I did this the whole way through, I think I had just camped a little bit down this way. I think I hiked 10 miles the first day. So, yay! Finally know I'm on the right trail.
Still, not exactly. It looked like this would be the best way to get around the downed tree, but then I couldn't find the trail again.
Before I wandered too far away and couldn't see the actual trail anymore, I came back to the trail. It looks like there's a whole bunch of trees back there blown over, and there has been tornadoes in southern Indiana, I know, so that just might be impassable, I think. And it doesn't look like there's a marked way to go the opposite direction of how I went, so okay, we'll just call that as far as I could go this way. Let's go north and see what is that way. Hopefully not more down trees. I remember when I was doing the whole trail, there was a lot of really cool creek areas, and I was hoping to find those again, but I don't remember any of the landmarks near them or what trailhead it was by, so I guess that'll just be a mystery forever. Alrighty, we are back to where the trail intersected with that horse trail I was accidentally on. Now let's go explore what lies this way. But I am getting pretty hungry, so let's explore this way a little bit until I find a spot to sit down and eat. So for a little lunch, what I brought, not lunch, but like a snack, tuna and two of these fruit bars, because that's all that normal backpacking food I had in my house. Not even backpacking food, just like stuff that's not gonna get gross in a backpack. So if you're wondering what happened to my hand, sorry if you've already heard me say this on my Instagram story and on the YouTube live I did the other night, but I burned myself with boiling water for the second time in my life. I don't know. Honestly, I'm kind of embarrassed. Like, every time I boil water now, I'm scared that I'm going to spill it on myself. And what do you know? I did. So, I don't know how that happened. I do know. I was trying to pour water from a pot, and it was going down the side of the pot, so I was like, okay, I'm just going to have to be brave and pour it quicker. I was pouring it into a French press coffee maker, which is pretty tall, and I was like, it's not gonna splash back up on me. And it did. So this tuna is tomato basil flavor and olive oil. And honestly, it is a very new taste to me. But I'm just telling myself it's pizza flavored. A nice pizza flavored packaged tuna. I take back everything I said. This is actually super delicious. You just have to get used to it. It really is pizza flavored. Another thing, in case you missed it, little life update, is that I'm trying to take my van out west, do a bunch of day hikes, backpacking trips, paddleboarding, but I've run into some delays. First, I thought my battery was having a problem that fuels the like living space in the back. Turns out it's just the fridge that's having a problem. So that's kind of a good thing, but I still haven't figured out how to fix the problem. I'm trying to get that taken care of before I hit the road. Another thing is that I'd really like to do a van tour to kick off the, being back in my van. A lot has changed since the first van tour I did, but my camera, it's a Nikon T30. It's not really working properly, like the focus, and just a lot of things are wrong with it. I want to use that to film my new van tour because, just want to make it be the highest quality that I can. So many little things that are delaying me, but I am trying as hard as I can to get on the road. I already have the map planned out, or the route planned out. I can't wait. Kind of an unrelenting uphill, but it's the Knobstone Trail, one of the hilliest places I know of. I'm just wandering into this campsite to see if there's a view, and I think there is. Cool. Look at that. I wonder what city that is. Maybe Louisville? I stopped suddenly because I could tell I was about to walk into this spider web. I can't believe I got that in focus, honestly. He's so cool, so colorful. Hey, buddy. Thanks for letting me look at your web. Okay, it's been about 5 minutes of me standing here trying to film this spider. It's right up here. I'm going very carefully around. Don't want my backpack to knock it down. Okay. Bye, buddy. That was so cool. Mile 10? I thought I was going northbound. Okay, so is this the way back to my car? Oh my goodness. I don't even know what to say. Where am I? Okay, so I guess when I set out, I don't even know. It looks like I'm gonna get back to the car. That's all I care about. There's the road. Okay, I know where I am now. I hid my water stash behind that tree when I did it last year. Looks like it's a popular spot for water stashes. And here we are, back out onto the road. Oh, I see my car way down that way. Dude, why didn't I? When I was first looking for it, this is the direction I came in at first. Didn't see the trail, so you live and you learn, I guess. Next time I come do this exact trail, I'll know where to go. Ah, what a beautiful day. Thank you so much for coming along. And hey, if you enjoyed this video, I hope you consider subscribing if you haven't already. Have a good one. Take care. Thank you for watching. Bye.